So, I want to describe a little bit how our emotions, especially our emotions, which are these containers of energy, work with each other. Yeah. How every one of us is in a secret network, not so secret really, but maybe not so conscious to you. Yeah. And you can study it, especially in a family. That is very interesting if you have children, but you can study it also as a couple. So think it. Well, you can think it with your hand, with the fingers, for example, no? Maybe you heard this sentence, everyone lives in his bubble, or everyone is an island. Have you heard that sentence? Yeah. Let's say it is like this. Yeah, we can agree somehow on that. No, we are not really in the same. Yeah, so you live in your bubble, I live in my bubble, but there is a connection. Yeah, and we can call it, for the sake of easiness, there is a connection like a pipe. Yeah, think it like a pipe where there would run water through it. Yeah, okay. If you like, you can think it also like an oil pipe. So now, when you have an emotion, yeah, anger, that's a very male emotion, for example, yeah. It is, if we had to divide our emotions, then we could say that women suppress anger and aggression, and men, what do they suppress? What do the men mainly suppress? Yeah. Fear and insecurity. Yeah. Right? So when you are angry, yeah, but you don't express it, yeah, you hold it down, yeah, you hold it down, you hold it down, you hold it down, yeah, and you are not aware of it. Not aware of it, that you hold it down. Yeah, it's just living in you on the other side, that you are not wanting to connect. No, you know it somehow. There is this killer can come anytime up. Yeah, but you don't want to connect with that, right? It's not attractive. So you hold it down, 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 down. Then there comes pressure in the pipeline. Yeah, and booms, in your wife it appears. Yeah. And you think that you are a cool person, yeah, that you are totally peaceful, and then you say, look at the wife and say, what is that? Yeah. And she freaks out. No? And when you do that over a long time, you know, you have permanently a wife next to you that freaks out. Finally, she goes to the psychiatrist, yeah, or to the therapist and psychoanalyst. And she says to the psychoanalyst, you know, I don't know what's happening to me. You know, I'm freaking out all the time, yeah, lately. Yeah. Why do you think that can be? And the therapist looks at her and says, what do you think? Yeah. Because the therapist also holds his emotions down. Yeah. You know, I don't know how many psychiatrists you met in your life. I met a lot. Yeah. Not because I went in one mental house after the other. But my life brought it like this, that I'm almost surrounded by psychologists, therapists, psychiatrists, people who work in general with people. Yeah, they appear a lot. And especially with the psychiatrists, I have never seen one that could not be his own patient. Yeah. Of course, imagine you work with people that are completely out of the box, yes? And you have to develop a kind of shield, a kind of system that holds you stable. Yeah. You can't really open. Yeah. You can't really let them in a way. So you become very, very controlled on a certain point. And somewhere it has to appear, right? And you will not believe how many psychiatrists are on drugs. you know, on all kinds of crazy medications. Yeah. So this kind of pressures is very important to understand. Now, in a family system, for example, the first ones who freak out is always the children. Yeah. What you put down, you will see it in the children. So in the West, we are the most aggressive people. So when you look at the children in the West, yeah, they scream, they go crazy, you know. Yeah, you might have seen that many times as well. Is it or not? Yeah. It's very important to understand that we give our emotions through this pipeline in the tank of the other person, yeah, in the emotional tank of the other person. Yeah. And that makes you maybe to understand a little bit better how the dynamics between you and the couple are. Yeah. So it is not that your wife becomes especially aggressive, you know. Yeah. But the thing is, because women usually want to have their aggressions down, yeah, they don't want to show, it's not very feminine to show anger and aggression, right? This is what they get told, no? Yeah. It's not very masculine to show your fear or your insecurity, no, your shakiness, right? So when we are easy with our own anger, yeah, when we are having it really close to us, bringing it to our conscious, yeah, it's like the anonymous alcoholics. You know, what's the first thing they do? They say, "Hello, my name is Peter. I'm an alcoholic." Yeah, you can say, "Hello, my name is Peter. I'm an angry person." Yeah. That would be the first step, no? Yeah, and then you talk about your anger. Yeah, how is your anger? No, every day, yeah? Because it is certain there. For certain, it is there, yeah? If there's one thing that manifests in our world as all there is, then it is anger first. Is it or not? Yeah, there is this anger against everything, against I am not as rich as I should be. Yeah, makes me very angry. There is so much injustice out there, makes me very angry. Yes, there is all kinds of this and that happening, makes me very angry. But a main anger is that people do not see me as I want to be seen. Yes, that I'm much more enlightened, much better, much lovelier, much more beautiful, whatever you want to see, much more brilliant, no, that anyone wants to see me. No one sees me, so what an anger is that? No? Is it? Mm. And then comes, of course, the brothers and the sisters of anger says, they don't give me attention, they don't give me recognition and so on. So all these things that we hold it down, yeah, because you don't run away, you don't run around and you say every day to yourself, I'm angry. Yeah. No. I met today my grandchild and I said to her, "Oh, my sweet one." And she said, "I'm not sweet." Yeah. I said, "Okay. I'm..." She said, "Sour." How can I translate it? Sour. I said, "Yeah, well, some kind of anger." Yeah. Let's say she said, "I'm angry." Yeah. I said, "Oh, okay. You're angry." Yeah. I said, "A little bit sweet." "No." She said, "Yeah, I'm angry." Yeah. I said, "Okay. Wow." And they can express that. And the children, we allow that, right? It's 3 years old. We don't say to them, "No, you cannot be angry." No. Of course, if they scream too much, because they love to scream, then, you know, the children, they can scream incredibly powerful, no? And they just scream, right? then of course we signal them, we don't like that. Yeah. There was a mother that came to me and said, you know, there is this, when I want to bring my daughter into bed, yeah, she always freaks out. Yeah. It's like I say the moment when I say, come, let's go to bed, she starts to freak out. Yeah. And she doesn't know anymore what to do. Yeah. I say, well, make it the way around. You freak out in front of her. Yeah. The next time you say, I'm going to go to bed, you just freak out. Yeah, you say, oh, I don't want that anymore. And I don't want to bring you to the bed. And I'm so fed up with this, you know, and so on. And you really freak out. Yeah. And she did it. And what was the reaction of the child was that she just looked to her mother, you know, and was completely peaceful. Yeah. Yeah, she was completely quiet. Of course. Yeah. So every time you see someone around you, yeah, functioning in a way that you say, oh my God, yeah, look how you deal with that emotion. Yeah. Is it present in you? Yeah. And you just hold it down. No? All right. And then look what happens around you. Yeah. Just look. Thank you.